And welcome back to Let's Play Grandia. We got stuff to kill. Carbon copy of the Ruined Guard. But his name is the Great Susano. Strategy. Destroy him. There's really nothing much. He's basically the same as the Ruined Guard, so we don't have to worry about that. No new attacks, really. The boomerang is instead replaced by an iron ball, which only has 1600 HP, which I am going to quickly take care of with the dragon cut and that. Rap. Let's have you... disc cutter. Axe. Hopefully that hits more than just the axe. Probably not, though. No. I should have targeted the Great Susano. If you haven't noticed, I'm actually in a rush to get through this. Because there's more after this. Hopefully I don't need to make this into a two-part episode. I really hope it doesn't end up that way. But we'll see what we can do. Justin. Come on, Justin. That's fine. I don't care where he is on the IP gauge. Dragon cuts instant.
Gadwin, secret move! Dragon King Slice!
I said earlier, I think, that I wouldn't be abusing the, I said earlier I wasn't gonna abuse Dragon Cut too much, but for this part I will, just to get through it. Double gain. He drops a whip, as you can see, which Fina will be equipping after this. I will cut that out. It's actually not as good as the God Knife as far as attack and whatnot goes. But, mid-air cut should finish up. But it adds +2 to move level, which I want for the next fight to make it very quick. But yeah, Chain Gem, and Revival, and Emperor Whip. We've already seen what the, there's nothing over there. We've already seen what the Chain Gem does. It adds +1 to combo attacks. That green flying thing again. This broken stuff. And that fell over. Another boss. Does he look familiar? It's the, dragon from the volcano again. It seems like they ran Phantom Dragon. Seems like they ran out of boss ideas, so they just reskinned it. That's okay. Head and body still share the same HP. He has 4,000 now. Well, rounded up.
Gonna thrash you good.
But yeah, this is just the way in to a line. Fina's gonna do no. Zap Whip. He still has Fire Breath, he still has Fire Spells, and he still has... Thar Cut. Still has, well, this one has Crackling as well. I don't know why a Dragon of Fire would have a Ice Spell. Doesn't make too much sense to me, but it's fine, I guess. Oh, hit Justin for 53. Yeah, it does hit hard, but again, no, his body cast Crackling. Stopping his body is somewhat difficult. He doesn't drop as good stuff as the first two. The first one drops tons of potions, two resurrection potions, and two other useful potions. And the other guy dropped the whip. I can't do Zap Whip again. That's poopy. Only 300. That's fine. Let's do Thor Cut again. 957. Rap should be able to finish this off with, like, a combo. And you can go to the save point between Susano and this guy, I believe. But there really isn't any issue to it. He's already dead. Two items. Oh, a blue potion and a gold potion. And a lousy 2,000 experience. Fina did level, though, but let's go into the Shrine of Lent, the place we're actually going to go. And I'm going to slow down now. I'm not in much luck. Hey, it's a Lietes right at the door to greet us. Third person talking? Look for my answers? We've talked before. What do you... Fina, what? Lietes? Oh, there's... a bunch of them. Why are there so many Lietes? There's like 5 or 6 or 7 of them. But let's go talk to them all. Hi, Liette. Okay. Oh. And she disappears. Every time you talk to one of them, they disappear. What? Oh. I guess Liette's learned some really cheesy pickup lines. Oh, there's only one that has life. She must live alone in silence. Okay. That answers that question about why there's more than one Lietes. Guard the memories of Angelo. Through sad eyes? Huh. Gaia is greed and evil that feeds on the spirit stones. Gaia is a degraded spirit stone. Wow, that... assimilate all spirits? Into the world of death. Well, okay, Gaia is a degraded spirit stone. Yeah. That's vaguely important. Is there anything actually around here? No. Only together with the Icarians. The result was Gaia. Oh. So the current Gaia is a reflection of General Bale? Or Ball, or however you're supposed to pronounce it. Okay, we know this. Oh, so that's the reason... Oh, since... broken into 7 pieces. So, since the Spirit Stone started bringing back together, that's why Fina and Lien were born the way they were. Arjba. So, all these races are actually different types of humans. And they used to live together. I wonder what happened. Must have been something with Gaia. Must be born as twins. Peace and harmony. Hearts are one. Blessing of the spirits on humans. Ah, so we're actually going to get to talk to the living Lietes. Huh. But I'll save that for the next part. There's a lot coming up. Another reason I wanted to rush through this episode, I'm sorry if, you know, you feel offended or whatever because I did that, but, they were just boss battles that I rushed through, and there wasn't too much dialogue anyway. But we found out some important stuff about Gaia and the Icarians, and what actually created Gaia, and the relationship between the general's greed and the form of Gaia. So, until next time, this is RPG Looney signing off.